quick. Livestock is like 5 minutes down the street from Stussy, and the Drift is next door. So those like the top three stores out there. So they are pretty close.
What's up? That's 8.5 cool.
Yeah.
Oh.
These on these hard. Birkenstocks 205 at the other store. I'm like, that nigga's crazy. This is hard. Don't mind my socks. I'm homeless out here. This 8.5.
That's your size?
Uh-huh.
Is it better than other ones?
Mm.
What size is the other
ones? 8.
Like
4 hours. I don't got no choice though. I was planning on getting out here. But I'm trying to find some good food right now. Mom, what up?
Hey.
Rogerson, I guess. Oh. My bad if I turn my camera hella quickly. I'd be nervous. Alright, landed in Toronto today around like 4 p.m. But plot twist, I don't have no fucking clothes. I landed back home in Oakland around like 11 p.m. last night, and I was late to check my bag, so it didn't make it, and it's in Oakland now. They said it was gonna be there at 8 a.m., but my flight to Toronto from whole San Francisco was from 8 a.m., so I was ass out. But I really wasn't mad because a trip is a trip. Like, I'm not gonna stress it, and it gave me a challenge. So my challenge is to find some outfits, and today that's what I did. First thing we did was, as soon as we got here, we went to Stussy, and then there was some stores around there. But let me show y'all what I did come with. I didn't come with no clothes at all. I got literally just this bag for a 5-day trip. So I didn't come with no clothes at all, but we're gonna see what we can do. I think it's a good challenge because I like putting shit together and I like shopping. So I was gonna do that anyway, but now I got no fucking choice. So got this jacket, this BDG little bomber jacket. This is what I came with. So got this, that's an option. Literally not nothing that I came with. But this too, it's a little bomber jacket, this vintage bomber jacket I got from the vintage vlog. I just had to buy some tank tops. I got 2 pair of drawers. I probably should have brought some drawers. That'll last me for now. And these jorts. Literally all I brought. And I got 3 pair of shoes, actually. I got these shoes I got on. These New Balances. I got my Margellas. And I got my Adidas Sambas. That's in the other room, but y'all know what those is. The white ones. So that's literally all I came out here with. So I got a shop and figured this shit out, which is cool. And this is a little BDG hat I got. I think this is dope, so. Yeah. So, yeah, went to the Stussy store. It was cool, the New York one was better, but this one was still cool. I got these. So, obviously I'm getting shit that's gonna go with a lot of other different stuff, so it make it easier. I don't gotta do no hard ass fits, but. Double knee, I guess my lighting not too good, but it is what it is. Double knee, Stussy jeans. The back hit, peep deets. Peep deets. Got these. These are like $200. The store was cool. This was the only thing I could find. They didn't have like a lot of shit from the drop, or it sold out. And then I went to Livestock and I got this hat. Hold on. Got this hat from Livestock, just on some chill shit. I think this is the right way, yeah. Just on some chill shit, this is hard. It's Artfield, Ikefield out. Something like that, I don't know. But this is some chill shit, like, feel me? I fuck with the buckets, and it's brown and white, so this can go with a lot of shit. It's hard. Grab that, this is like $90. I'll give y'all price breakdown, it don't matter, so y'all know how much it be. Nike socks, needed these, I didn't have no fucking choice, you feel me? Like, had to grab those. And then, so I went to, yeah, Stussy to get the pants, Livestock to get this and the socks. And then I went to the store next door. Shout out Duchesne at Livestock too. He was cool as hell. He gave me a whole list of stores to go to. People out here hella cool and genuine and shit. I fuck with them. But then he told me to go next door to, oh no, that's Livestock. Then he told me to go next door to Adrift. And that's where it was some fucking heat. And I probably got my best purchase. I'm gonna show y'all in a second. But this Vans, this is gonna go. This, the Carhartt pants, and these shoes I'm gonna show y'all are already a fit. So that's fit for a day. I'll probably wait till we're Saturday. I'll probably get a couple more fits tomorrow. I'm confident I'm gonna get fits though. I'm not worried. Like, that shit didn't get me down when my bag didn't come in. Like, it was what it was. I showed up late, so that's on me. So yeah, that polo was only like $20. And fucking these Birkenstocks is not fucking it. Get some different shit. These is different. These is fucking Vans. Never seen these before. He said it was new to dude Roger. Cool as hell. Shout out Roger. He was cool as hell. He showed me love in there. And yeah, I got these. These like, I think 115. I've been needed some clogs for so long, and these are fucking dope. They just like the Birkenstocks, but shit, I think they better, and they Vans, and they $100 less. I actually, they had Birkenstocks and Livestock. Them shits were like $200. Like, them shits not worth $200. These is cool. That's a whole fit with my Carhartt pants, that polo, and these. I'm gonna wear these a lot on the trip though. These just, I just need something cool to just throw over the pants. All right, my apologies. My mom walked in, but more detailed look at these. We're kind of like the gum bottom. These are just hard. Like, I don't know if they got these at the Van store and I just never peeped, but I was just in the Van store like a week ago and I did not see these, but I'm happy I went in Artfield or something like that. These is dope. Like, I just really needed some clogs and these is really clean. I think so. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments. But tomorrow, more shopping, and came out here with no plan, but we're gonna figure it out tomorrow. And get some good food, but it's gonna be a good vlog. I'm getting better, so yeah. All right, good morning. It's about 11:30. Didn't just wake up, but I'm just now getting ready, trying to figure out what I'm gonna wear. I'm not gonna wear that fit I bought. I think I'm gonna wear that like Saturday, but I got these jorts. Hopefully y'all can see them. And I didn't really get to wear these like in a fit pick yet. I don't know if this fit gonna be hard enough to take a pick, but we're gonna see. But I'm deciding between wearing this. I just got a tank top. I got no shirt. Mind you, I came out here with no clothes. And I didn't get a shirt yesterday. We went to Walmart. I just got a tank top. I'm deciding between this and maybe the hat I was wearing. But I'm low-key thinking maybe this. So I'm thinking that jacket, maybe with the Marzellas. Or maybe this jacket with this hat. Maybe in these. I don't know, we gonna see. So let me try it on and I'll show y'all each one. Okay, so this fit. I don't really know. Like, it look cool from like this up, but I don't really know. You can't really see the shoes, but the samba's not really going. I don't know if it's giving yet. It's kind of mid. Maybe I should just wear the other fit today, because I'm gonna find a fit for Saturday. But I was thinking about wearing that fit Saturday, but this look cool, but I don't know. Yeah, maybe I'll come this. I like how this jacket looking. I don't know if I should go hat or no hat. I think either way though. was thinking about maybe wearing a hoodie under too. I think the hat low key go though. I don't want to be wearing too much green. I got on. Jeez. But I don't know. I think that look kind of cool. I'll probably rock with this. But quick views. This is where I got y'all propped up at too. Genius. But damn. Can't really see, but hold on. Yeah, quick views for today. It's the view from the apartment. It's like some graffiti right there, and then it's the city right over there. But I don't know what the vibes today is. We're trying to figure it out. My mom trying to go to the mall. I'm trying to go to some thrift shops and like Contraband, I think I seen was a cool streetwear store. And I don't know, another store. But the mall should be cool. I heard it's a big ass mall. Maybe we go to the aquarium, but we finna go get some breakfast at this little spot. I'm gonna show y'all, but I think I'm feeling the fit. Let me know if it's cool. Some chill shit. But yeah, see y'all. All right, so real quick, we on the waiting list at the little Mildred place. So I'm gonna talk to y'all real quick about the fucking crazy ass exchange rate. So we just went to this bank and we're trying to see like how the exchange rate. My mom withdrew exchanged 500 US and got 650 Canadian back. And I did 190 US and I got 250 Canadian back. So, and then it made me think like, damn, I wonder how it is on the car. Cause I used my car yesterday, all day shopping. So my Stussy pants was 200. They charged me 150 on my card. At the other store where I got the clogs, them it charged me it was 158 total and they charged me 117 on my card. So the exchange rate is crazy. I don't know what the exact rate is, but obviously everything kind of cheaper out here. So that's perfect. So probably not good for my shopping addiction, but it's perfect because everything gonna be cheaper out here, so I can get more stuff. So yeah, keep that in mind while y'all here. Everything cheaper using a card or exchanging your cash. Just got to the mall. It's like five different entrances, so this is like the main one. Cheers. The Saks now, and I always see this piece online, but I've never seen it in store. It's made some Margiela piece, crazy. Feel the details in it. That's some dope shit up in here, though. I'm gonna just show y'all. No, I got to. So right now I'm just walking around. I ditched mom, so I was trying to go to these shops and I didn't want to trailing me and shit. So I went to Nomads and Creeps. I thought Creep was gonna be cool, but that shit was like an all-girl store. Nomads was like kind of like high price design, like a Cold Wall, Acme Studios and shit. So I didn't really get nothing from there. But I'm heading to the thrift stores now. But there's some streetwear stores I still ain't been to, like Contraband, and I think like Nomad or some shit like that it's called. So I'll probably go to those tomorrow and figure out what else I'm gonna do tomorrow. But yeah. All right, so I'm at Throwback Vintage right now. They got some cool shit. I'm trying to definitely get some vintage Canada shit, so that look cool. It's got some Toronto shit on it. Flag on the back, that's all right. Because I know. Oh, shit, you've been to Canada. Yeah, nigga, I have. You haven't. Got these.
Fuck. Get faded on. Pussy. These cool. You always I always try shit on with pants and my shoes. So you can see how I look with these cool. Good fading. It's hard. So I'll probably get these. These probably, if this goes, this probably go with this. Something light. Mind you, I don't have a choice, so let's keep that in mind. But yeah, these are. So I kind of fuck with these too. Dope new joints. I always wanted some like light car ones. I mean, light car hard ones. I really want some dark brown ones or some brown ones, but these might do. I might get fuck with these. Trying to throw something together quick. These are the Levi's I tried on. It's fading crazy on these. Hella clean. Yeah, I heard oversized tees out of style, but I'm gonna have to grab this one just because it's hard. Take Canada and shit. But I'm starting to fuck with the smaller tees, but I still like oversized for real. So I might grab this. This last thing I'm trying on. Those wasn't it. Yeah, it's tough. Good crop joint. I like how the pocket's super high too. The back. It's clean. I'm gonna have to grab this. Need some vest. Alright, good morning. It's now Saturday. I'm getting ready. It's like 11. Getting ready to throw in that fit I told y'all I was gonna throw in on Saturday. Make sure you see that before anything. That's this patch. Make sure you see that before anything. And it's so fucked up. Oh, you got polo drawers on too, like. But it ain't really nothing though, but you got them on. And of course. Super comfortable and they look cool. I don't think I'm going to show y'all, but I don't think you can really see. But yeah, anyway, vibing out. I listened to Drake the whole time I've been out here, so I was just listening to some Drake. But putting on my fit now. Probably gonna go walk around with my mom, get dressed and shit. But show y'all these new pickups real quick. We'll start with that. That's crazy. Went to Throwback Vault yesterday. I went to Nomad. And Creeps was freaking girls' clothes. So I just walked in there and walked out. But Nomad was cool. They had like kind of like designer pieces, which I ain't spending that much money. I like more streetwear because it's like, it's clean, but it's not too pricey. But yeah. Got these faded ass Levi's. This fade is just crazy. Like, you could just see like over time how it faded. Or maybe I'm just telling myself that because I want to be fake vintage guy, but I think they are and they fit clean. Orange tab, that means something, right? I mean, like they old and shit. I don't know. I'll be fake vintage, but yeah, got these. These are like $58. I'm just not sure if I try on shit, but yeah. Then I end up grabbing this. This was like 78, so like 50 Canadian probably. I didn't check my account because I use my card, but I'm guessing they charge me probably like 50 for this, but yeah. Super hard. I just had to get like a Toronto like vintage piece to show I was really out here, and you can't get this nowhere in California or United States, I'm guessing. But yeah, super hard. Try it on real quick for y'all. I'm gonna probably wear this Sunday, but I need like a Canadian like trucker hat to go with it. That's the vibe I'm going for. But I don't know what to wear under it. But it low key looked like on some street shit, like just regular detached rocket. But yeah, this is hard. And I like how the pocket's high, like that shit is crazy. Does it like that? But yeah, it's clean. Spent like 150 on both Canadian, so I'm guessing that's like, I don't know, 120 US. I use my card, I use my cash. Bruh, my freaking $20 rip. I don't know why I didn't put it in my wallet. I wasn't thinking like it was cash, so I usually put cash in my wallet, but I just put it in my pants. Bro, my bill ripped. And I heard they don't take like taped up bills, so I'm ass out, which is unfortunate, but it is what it is. Got that, so yeah. Putting on this fit. Today, I think I'm gonna hit the aquarium. I'm gonna hit, I keep forgetting Kith just opened up out here, which is perfect time. It just opened Friday. So I'm gonna probably go there today. And Contraband, that's like Yorkville, that's like the bougie part of town. So I'm probably hitting that area today and hopefully get some pics. Not hopefully, I am gonna get some pics because I need pics. So yeah, I'm gonna take this picture serious, but yeah. This is a small, I wasn't finna get it because it was small, but it fit cool. Like it's a cool little crop. So, run this, some slutty shit. I like polo. I like this. Come soon. Yeah. I like this. I like just wearing my shit. Just. I come soon. No, it's polo. No, be honest. You want the full breakdown, I'm gonna tell you, follow. So yeah. Just want some chill shit. So yeah, full break, fit breakdown right here. Yeah, Vans shirt, Stussy pants, and then the Vans. Cause I don't know if y'all can see them when I have y'all propped up. But I really wanted like pants to lay all the way over them to where you can't even see damn near the heel. But this I have to do. But most of my pants lay all the way over my shoes. But this will for sure do. But I'm happy that fit came out. But you know what's so fucked up that make me mad? When I got Prada and Burberry shades, and I don't know which ones to wear, bruh. Like, I hate this shit because the Prada's gold. But it's like, should I come, like, the Prada's gold, but like, should I come bird? Like, it's the hardest decision ever, bro. Like, oh my God, bro. That shit make me fucking mad. But I don't know, bro. That shit damn near fucked up my day. But yeah, see y'all when I get out. Gonna hit this aquarium. Shit. Blue Jay Stadium. And it's a fucking Yankees game the day after we leave, which I'm fucking hot about. But I should have seen that because they're in the same conference. And I fucking love the Yankees. Well, if y'all don't know, now you do know. But, yeah. It's a good little area. Tourist ass area. Yorkville right here, the bougie part of Toronto. That's a nice bridge, don't know what it's called. But they had like a bunch of like designer stores, like nice restaurants and shit here. This Contraband I headed in, they had like designer and like streetwear, acting studios, Margiela, a bunch of other shit. I ain't really getting nothing out of there. And then this is Kith right here, just opened Friday. And this is Saturday, so it's a long line, but respectfully, I'm not waiting in no line for a store that I might go in and not even get nothing. I could have got in, like, I knew, like, bro, I know people out there, but I ain't even gonna pull my, you know, strings. Yeah, and then they just had a bunch of alleys and restaurants in the alleys. Everybody was just, like, you know, dressed nice and still with nice bags and all of that. You could tell, like, they really, like, they on some bougie shit. We'll be right back.
right, I'm gonna take this time to do my Toronto recap. But real quick, I went to this like Toronto Nuit Blanche thing downtown. It's supposed to be like art like spread out throughout downtown, which sounds dope, but it was bunk as hell because the art wasn't no real art. But yeah, I rate Toronto like a 8-9 out of 10. It was cool. It didn't feel like out of the country. It just gave me like Seattle and like New York vibes, which is cool. Like, I ain't tripping. I'm getting my experience and everything. But the one thing about Toronto, it was a lot of like stanky people. Like, no disrespect, I promise, no disrespect to Toronto, but it was some stanky motherfuckers out there. Like, I don't know what they got going on. But yeah, it was cool. The food was kind of mid, but the people were really nice though, so that made up for it. But real quick, what the hell is this? This is not art. People call anything art. Motherfuckers trying to analyze this shit. It's nothing to analyze. This shit suck. Like, this is not no art. And then this one, I'm starting to think Toronto, like bad. Like, bro, Miles Morales is not on shit. Motherfuckers talking about, oh, like, he just picked this nigga up. Like, and this is when my night was over. Like, I just headed home early. Finished my review of Toronto. I'm on this 2-hour train ride to Niagara Falls, which was cool. Like, I love train rides and shit. Like, it's just, you know, soothing and shit. But yeah, it was cool out there, and I like how it was like kind of like New York. Like, you could walk everywhere. Like, I was like in Yorkville, and I could like walk downtown, and I damn near could like walk to my place. Like, I like places that you can, you know, walk everywhere. Like, I don't gotta catch no lifts and catch no subways and shit. And I, like I said, I really love the people out there. Like, they were like super genuine. I hope nobody get mad at me because I said people out there kind of stink. Like, if you come to Oakland and say people in Oakland is ratchet, then I'm not gonna be mad at you. Like, you feel me? That's your point of view. Like, you come to the city and you view it how you want to. But definitely still mad I didn't get to go to the Yankees game. It was the day after I left, and I never been to Yankees game, and it was in Toronto. That would have been perfect, but can't dwell on it. Also, not mad, but I wish I would have went to Kensington Market. It's supposed to be like a vintage type area, some stores and like some food to eat. And, you know, I probably could have met some people there. And that's what I'm also mad about, that I ain't get like more people Instagram. Like, I just like getting people Instagram from different places. So, you know, I see what they own, and maybe when I go back there, I have somebody to chill with.
So we hopping on this bus to go to Table Rock.
So it's damn near not raining. This shit just damn near the falls. This shit crazy. I'm happy I wore 2 jackets, I would have been ass out. Hungry as fuck. Shit. It's like 12. Whew. A little closer. I jump, nigga. Fuck around. This shit crazy. And every day, I can't go back. I'm too far when I sit and think. For real, nigga.
Can't really see, but fuck, I can't see. There we go. Beautiful. I think I'm gonna grab this for my best friend. This shit hard. Or I might have to keep it. Might have to let me wear this. This shit tough. But I think I'm gonna grab this hat for me. Seriously, it kind of goes with the fit. Yeah. But I was thinking about throwing some patches on the bag.
That'll maybe be hard, even though it's already Canada. Niagara Falls patch might be hard. $5. I might. Yeah, the whole thing. It's kind of cool. Yeah.
Everybody having everybody take each other pictures for them. Shit dope. Shit. Yeah, Ferris wheel over there. On the whole other side, they got people. Shit. Shit beautiful. Miraculous. Train station right now. Niagara Falls is dope as hell, but can't stay there for too long. We stayed like an hour and a half, but waiting on this train right now. But here, because I was trying to show y'all, I can't really see it, but I love like little cities like this and fucking train stations. Make me feel like I'm in a movie and I gotta go get my girl back or some shit at the train station. But yeah, that shit was dope. We hoping we going the right way. Because the train came this way, but we gotta go that way. So, low key trying to get lost though, if that makes sense. Not really though.
So, we got back to that train station from Niagara Falls at like 2, and then we seen the train. The next train wasn't coming till like 4. So, and then we asked this dude, he told us to get on this bus to another train station. It'd be like 45 minutes, but the bus ride was like 2 hours. But wasn't tripping, though. End up getting to the next train station at, like, exactly 4:10, like, 5 minutes before the train came. And the train ride was a little shorter, so it ended up working itself out. And we got to see, like, you know, some cool shit on the bus ride that we haven't seen. But, yeah, that's pretty much the video. Really appreciate y'all if y'all made it this far in the video or watched any of my videos or supported me in any way, because it's really what I want to do, like, coming from Oakland, I don't feel like it's not a, I don't know a lot of people doing like YouTube or, you know, just doing different stuff than what everybody else doing. So that's kind of my objective, to show the people in the city it's a different way to do shit. So hopefully I get somewhere with it to show people, you know, coming up that it's a different way to do shit. You can experience different things and just me experiencing life, showing y'all. And I really want to be like a different YouTuber. Like, I don't edit my videos a lot. And I kind of like it like that because I want my shit to be raw. And if y'all think I'm cool, then y'all gonna watch my shit regardless.